south of Alexandria between Woodworth and Glenmora, there's a hidden sight to behold. What would you say if you came upon a complete turn-of-the-century lumber mill complex in the pine forest abandoned for decades? Well, like me, you'd say of number 7.
What in the world is it?
It's a skidder.
Now, you got to tell me what that is.
A skidder skidded logs. It actually, they would cut the logs down, cut the limbs off, and this machine would drag them as far as 1,000 feet on either side of the track.
Since it closed in 1969, Don Powell dreamed of turning Longleaf Mill into a museum complex. Although it's not as well known as such a petrified wonder deserves, tour groups are booking more visits to the museum that time rusted frozen.
You're not exactly in deep trouble here, and this isn't falling down. You're fixing it.
We're no longer endangered. We can go to the almost to the bottom of the list. I have enough flooring here to complete the floor. We do that with volunteer help. And the new roof.
That's some of the extra roof.
And this is the extra material that was left over, which will go on another building that we're going to work on soon.
Mm-hmm.
But this building, which was built in 1910, of course, it's on the National Register of Historic Places. They made products here that are practically unheard of now. Beaded ceiling, 105 drop siding. That was the outside exterior for many, many millions of homes in the United States. They also made bar rail, chair rail, crown mold, shoe mold. All this is the molding machine right here. And they would ship it out, and they're little small specialty pieces. But primarily they made what we call dimension lumber, which is 2 inches thick, 2x4s, 2x6, 2x8, 2x10, 2x12.
Ordinary things are most poignant at the Longleaf Mill. At Disneyland, they scatter old train parts alongside the track of the little train. Here, giant rusted gears from the steam era have actually laid beside the track for who knows how long.
And it would pull them with cables.
It would, and tongs would hook to the end of the log or choker cables, and they would drag them up here, stack them alongside the track, and as they filled them up, cleaned the area out, they'd move on down. It was self-propelled. Now, it wouldn't move fast. If you moved it any distance, you'd hook it in the train. Now, there were 2,000 of them made.
And how many are left?
That
like
one?
Yours here.
That
no, I mean, how many are left in the world of 2,000 made?
One. This is it. This is the last one of them. We know of a piece of one in West Virginia, but we cannot find any other evidence or anything of one, because in those days, those drums were valuable. The steam engine was valuable.
They tore them apart.
They would tear them apart and sell them and salvage them. This is out of 2,000. This is the last one left. But just to show you something, that these people never threw anything away, we've got the parts catalog that came with this machine on display in 1919 is when we got it.
This landmark is haunted by real working hands full of feeling in the everyday. Being named to the top endangered sites has helped Don Powell raise money for a new roof over the planer mill. So this too is a success story in the works.